This
सारी
conference will
जाए
now be recorded.
नो जमाल इज देयर, जमाल इज देयर,
या आई एम चेकिंग दैट.
यस
ओके, एनी क्वेश्चंस?
नो फ्रॉम माय साइड नो, बट आई बिलीव एज सून एज वी स्टार्ट टू वर्क and work center and you can show us all the detail if I have any
Yeah.
question. This is it is very simple, I believe, until now. Yeah,
Okay.
thank you.
Okay, thank you. So I'm opening my system. I will show
Thank you.
yesterday. Yeah, yesterday we are discussing on the work center. What is the purpose and how we can use it. Now I will show you in SAP. Hi
Yeah,
Jamal.
good. Hi.
Yeah, hi, good evening.
Good evening, good morning.
Yeah, thank you. Are you able to see my screen now?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm opening the SAP. I will show you how to create work center and different fields in work center. The menu path is logistics, production, master data, and work centers. Work center create. So this is the initial screen of a work center. Here, first we will enter the plant. And then any name of work center. Work center, you can give any name here. Like I am giving work center 001. And then here, work center category we need to give. Work center category is like this work center we are using for what purpose. SAP has defined some standard categories like this work center is a machine, or it is a labber, or it is a group of machines. Work center machine group means it is a group of machines. So which type of work center we are defining, we need to select. I am selecting this as a machine and then press enter. So once you press enter, it will open create work center basic data. Like material master.
There was a question
Yeah.
here. What is why group of machine or machine? For example, I understand yesterday we have been working on machine, but the group of machine does mean the same work center is, it has multiple machine or what you mean on this one?
Correct. Same work
Yes.
center, you will have a multiple machines because
Okay.
the reason is each individual machine you don't want to create as a work center.
Okay.
Four or five machines together you want to make as a one work center, and you want to measure the your cost and activities. So that case we will create one work center for group of machines. Okay. Now here, like material master, you have a multiple tabs here. We will maintain the values here. So first is work center description, name of the work center. I can say assembling machine. They're assembling the car. Okay, assembling car. This is my work center. In basic data, first is some fields like Person responsible is nothing but a person who is maintaining that work center, supervisor or manager. That person, you can put his name here. And then uses, this work center, like BOM uses, this work center can be used in a multiple areas, like inspection plans, routings, networks, rate routings. All these are the applications, means all these are, we need to use this in a different applications. So where we are using this work center, we need to maintain. Generally, we will maintain this as a 009 all task list. So this work center can be used in routings, can be used in inspection plans for QM module, networks, maintenance task means PM module. So this work center can be used in all. So generally, we can select 009 all tasks. So now here next field is standard value key. This is important thing.
Yes.
Standard value key. So yesterday I told you this work center can be used to measure your machine. Machine means how many hours it is running, like that. And you can use this for the labor also. Labor means how many workmen is working on this machine. Okay, and this machine can be used for setup time. Setup means before starting of the machine, you require some activities, like maybe cleaning or make it ready that machine. That is called the setup. You are setting up that machine before starting your assembly. So these are the some parameters you are measuring in work center. So these group of parameters we will maintain in one key, that is called the standard value key. In the standard value key, we will maintain what are the parameters we would like to measure in this work center. Okay, that group we will maintain here. For example, these are the standard SAP keys: normal production, variable production, process, production line. All these are the SAP standard, not Y, but it is the SAP 0 to SAP 6. For example, if I take the SAP 1, normal production. So inside of this key, if I press enter, I am pressing enter now, you will get the what are parameters we are going to measure in this one. It will display here in the bottom. Now I am just pressing enter. Now you can see it is displayed three keys. One is setup, another one is mission, third one is a labor. So that means in this work center, we are planning to measure these parameters. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay.
So we set up, it is a standard setup, or we set it up ourselves, SAP 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is it now it is 6, but we can set up whatever we like, or it is a standard?
Yeah.
Okay.
SAP standard is okay. You can maintain also. You can create your own also. Okay. Mm-hmm. How to create is here. You can see create values. It will open your configuration. Okay. Define standard value keys.
Yeah.
Where does
the screen come from?
I did not see it earlier.
Yeah, the screen come late.
Did you go in configuration or SPRO that you
Yeah, I'm now showing you in configuration SPRO. Okay, this you can go to the configuration also. I'm showing in a configuration. This is SPRO. I'm going to the production now. Production. And in the production, you can open the basic data.
It's
Under
not
basic.
okay. Now it's showing. Okay, good.
You're able to see production,
Yeah.
Then basic data, then click on work center, then click on general data. Here you can see standard value. Expand this standard value, and here define standard value key. Execute.
I have a question. If you scroll down, and
Okay.
there are some other keys. One is production, and other one is says production planning. Since we are working production planning, is the production and production planning is two? Why is two different?
Yeah.
Mention.
So you mean to say this one or production and production planning for process industry? These two, you mean to say, correct?
No, if you go back to the SPRO.
So I'm in SPRO.
Okay, now can you scroll down later?
Okay.
It says, okay, this is a one say production, then it says production planning for processing.
Yeah,
then
correct.
Advanced planning. This advanced planning is different, but why it's two different field, production and production planning.
Okay. So in initially
for pharmaceuticals, is it right? The for
yeah,
process
I'm coming.
And yeah, for pharmaceuticals. Yeah.
Correct. Okay.
I'm
So
sorry.
Yeah, I'm explaining you. In initial starting classes, I explain you discrete manufacturing. Okay.
Yeah.
And process manufacturing and repetitive. These are the three business scenarios in our PP module.
Right.
Okay. So this discrete manufacturing related configuration is available in that production path.
Okay.
Okay. In the production path, all configuration related to discrete and repetitive is available. Okay.
And
but specific to, yeah, repetitive and specific to process industries, you can see a different folder here. Production planning in process industries. Okay. This is a separate folder for process related configuration. This is that field. Okay. Production planning for process industries. You can see. So process industry related configuration is available in this path. Is this clear?
So the production process is in planning, right?
Yeah. Production planning for process industries is for process related configuration. Chemical
okay.
industries and pharma.
Okay. So it means when you work in a production planning, you have three kind of production, which is one is a discrete and the repetitive will cover
correct
discrete and
correct
the process will cover the planning process.
Correct.
Production.
Correct.
Okay.
Yes.
So anytime
okay.
you do the production planning, I mean, anytime you do the process, production process, you will go to planning.
Correct.
Okay.
I will go to production process, process industries, that node I need to check. Okay. And one more thing is, if some parameters are
when you work
yeah.
on a system SPRO,
yeah.
the the SPRO is not showing. You are working on Excel. Excel is there, but the SPRO screen is not showing.
Okay. Now you are able to see my Excel file?
Yes.
Okay. Now I came to the SPRO.
Right. Now.
Are you able to?
Yes.
Are you able to see now? Okay.
Yes.
That's fine. Okay. Now your another question is, what is advanced planning here?
Right.
Okay. This advanced
APO?
Yeah, exactly. This is nothing but a PPDS module. APO PPDS module, I told you, this is embedded into S4HANA now. So that what are the configuration related to PPDS module? It is under advanced planning.
So APO means advanced planning.
Yeah, correct.
Advanced planning. No,
yeah.
No, advanced planning and what? What is O stands for?
Oh, you mean to say APO? What is the meaning of APO? Advanced planning and optimization.
Optimization.
Yeah, this is a separate system actually.
Okay, and what is the PPT stand for?
Okay, production planning and detailed scheduling.
Production planning.
We will do it. Is this part of our class or not?
Yeah, PPT it is a part of our class. I will give some introduction and I will show you the scenario PPDS at the end.
Production planning and detail scheduling. And what is T stand for?
T.
Yes.
T is not there here. PPDS.
You say PPT. Oh, PPDS, I'm sorry, okay.
PPDS, production planning and detailed scheduling.
Details, okay, I'm sorry, I misunderstood.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So now I'm going to the standard value key. Production, basic data, and I am opening the define standard value key. So here, once you open this standard value key, you can either you can copy the normal production, and you can see you can enter whichever you want the parameters. Okay, and you can put this is a Z001 or ZSAP SA1.
Okay, it's not showing here.
Jamal, are you able to see?
Now it's come, but when you were start the first, it was not showing. I think the screen is coming today late.
Okay.
Yes, you are right.
Okay.
The standard value key. Now, can you please go back and
yeah.
Show us again. I want to see standard.
Okay. So now I am there in the initial screen of standard value formula.
Okay.
You are able to see SAP 0, SAP 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You can select standard any one of this one and click on copy.
Okay.
So when you copy, it will show you another screen.
Right.
Change view, standard value, key formula.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Here you can put your any name here. Normal production. Some name like I'm giving the Honda.
Mm-hmm.
And here you can give the 6 parameters. Okay. Like setup, machine and labor. For example, you don't want to set up. You don't want to measure setup. Only you want to measure machine and labor.
Mm-hmm.
So you can select only machine and labor only.
Okay. Just to, you know, from your you work in many production projects. Usually, what
Your voice is not clear.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm moving the speaker. From your experience, which one they take, for example? Because surely you work in many different projects.
Yeah.
So which one they set up for this kind of standard value key, for example, keys? Thank you, sir.
Generally, we will use the normal production, like setup, mission, and labor. These three only.
Okay.
Because this is a configuration, we won't change frequently. If I don't want setup time, so I will maintain zero value in the routing actually. We will use this in the routing master data. So that time, in place of standard value, I will put the zero.
Now, what is the other field in this parameter? If you drop down, can you see it?
Yeah. For example, here you can see setup, mission, labor.
Okay.
This is SAP has given.
Okay.
OP time one, time two, some anything if you want, you can use it. Tear down requirements.
Okay. So in this scenario that we are using only for work center, machine and labor.
Yeah.
So we don't need, we don't need any other like 3, 4, 5, 6 or whatever. This is the requirement. This is the standard that you work on a work center.
Yeah. Example, for example, I'm saying, okay, how to create this.
Standard value.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you want to use setup, mission, and labor, already we have the standard key SAP one that you can use.
Okay, in the bottom it says generate. So is this also a standard?
No. This tick mark and checkbox is also a standard.
I see. Okay.
It will generate this formula. That's all.
Okay.
Maybe after when we set it up for production center, if you add any value in this one, you should decrease the rate or not. That means today I use this one, ZSA1, with two parameters. But tomorrow, the future after 2-3 months, maybe if I need to add any more value, I can add more parameters, for example, for this one, or no, this one stay like this forever.
No, you can add also. After some time, you want to add another parameter, you can add.
This is just for training purpose.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm clicking OK button to save this. I'm saving it.
So my question is, when you create any work center, different assembly or different plant or different anything, you have to create the work center, and then you have to go and create the standard value key for every work center, correct?
No, if your work center want to maintain only standard one, you don't require to create. The parameters are having the different combinations. Like normal production, we saw the three are there, setup, mission, and labor. But you want a different one, only you want to measure mission and labor. So that time only you need to create. Otherwise, it is not required.
Okay, if we select the standard value, is this standard value, then its work center will work for every application.
Yeah, you can use the same standard value key for other work centers also.
I see. Okay.
Okay. Now I am going back to work center.
It's not going back.
Yeah, I'm showing. Now you are able to see the work center screen?
No, it's a SPRO screen actually.
Yeah. which is showing as a work center.
No, this is a work center basic data.
Yeah,
now
that's correct. Okay.
Yeah.
Now we are in work center basic data screen.
Mm-hmm.
So here in the standard value key,
mm-hmm.
you can see whatever we created now. ZSA1 normal production Honda.
Okay, now one more question here. When you set up the standard value key,
okay,
and you did not set up the setup, means at the top one, and machine labor setup, why is showing here setup then?
No, we are not selected now. We are not at selected this key. Now I am just selecting it.
I see.
Okay, and now I am pressing enter.
Mm-hmm.
Now you can see.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Good.
So this is the very important value in work center. Okay.
Right.
Standard value key.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So after this one, we need to go to the default values.
Okay. One more question here. There is another field. It says the rules of maintain, and then after there is another value, it says K. So what is that for?
Actually, key for performance efficiency rate. Efficiency rate. This is the efficiency rate is like its efficiency is 100%. If you not maintain anything here, the machine efficiency is like 100%.
Okay, so can you click this? We'll see what kind of value we have here.
Yeah.
With the K.
Yeah. You can see. These are the two values, 001 sample and MK1. You can maintain this in a configuration.
I see.
Efficiency rate, you can maintain it and you can select it.
I see. Okay. And the other thing, after K, there is another key, there is another icon that I want to see that's all the way up to the end. Up, right here, this one.
Right, you don't have any, only description.
The after, after description, there is a blue key and something. Can you maintain here something?
This one?
No, little up. Your cursor is not moving, so can you go little up, please?
No, it is completely up. Yeah,
just it says description and all the way description in the end.
Oh, after description nothing is there.
No, there is one square box with the blue and a black shade mark.
Yeah, correct. This is, you will see this button in all of the screens, most of the screens, wherever you see this one is nothing but the sequence of this table.
So
like configuration means this description K and everything is there. So
okay,
these, it will change the configuration, you can see.
I see. Okay.
Want to, it is like a table settings.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
This is, you will see commonly wherever you see the screen like table.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'm moving to the next tab. Default values. Okay, here mainly we will maintain the unit of measure for standard values. Unit of measure, we selected machine and labor. For these two, how you want to measure? Okay, these generally we will measure in a unit of measure like time, machine time. So the time is like hours or minutes, we will maintain unit of measure.
Okay.
Okay. That means it will say you 10 hours it is running time.
Right.
Okay. Labor also will maintain in a time only. The reason is 5 labors are working for 8 hours. Each labor is 8 hours. So their total working is 40 hours.
Now, did we mention any place that 5 labors are working?
No, we won't mention as 5 labors, we will mention as hours only, 40 hours.
I see. And what about the other keys that it's a operation default value? We don't need to fill up this other values like control
yeah.
keys.
Here it is not required, but
I see.
Here it is a control key is an important field.
Hmm.
Okay.
Hmm.
This same control key we will use in routing. Routing means another our next master data.
Next master. Okay.
Okay, I will explain you that.
But we cannot maintain the control key here in default value in WorkCenter.
I'm coming to that.
Okay.
Okay. I'm entering here mission hours as a hour. Okay. Now, here operation default values means whichever you maintain the values here, these will get copied into the another master data routing. When I'm maintaining the routing, that time I will use this work center. Okay. That time the values maintained here will automatically get copied.
I see.
That is called the default value. Okay.
I see.
For example, I am just selecting the one value, but importance and everything I will explain you in the routing.
Okay.
Okay. For example, I am maintaining the PP01.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So if I maintain this value, when I'm creating routing, that time this value will come as a default.
I see.
That is the meaning of default values, operation default values.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So these remaining things also the same thing. Whatever you maintain here, it
mm-hmm.
will come in routing master data.
I see. And what about the other right side? It says reference and check mark there.
Yeah. If you tick mark this one, so this value which is coming from here in the routing master, you
mm-hmm.
cannot change in the routing.
If you check mark it.
Yes. If you not check mark it,
mm-hmm.
it will show you the default value, but in the routing master you can change also.
I see. Okay.
Okay. Next I'm going to the next screen. Capacity.
Yes. One second, please. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. This capacity tab is important.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So in this capacity tab, we will maintain some formulas. Okay. And we will maintain other parameters also.
Mm-hmm.
What are the other parameters? I will show you. First is capacity category. I think someone is asked capacity categories we will create in a separate screen. Okay. Separate transaction code. We can create a separately or we can create in this tab actually. Okay. So now this capacity related, like mission capacity related data, everything we will maintain in this tab. So what is that? First is we are creating this as a mission, work center as a mission. So first we will select the category, its category as mission.
I see.
Okay. So you can select 001.
Mm-hmm.
And once you select this one, at the bottom,
mm-hmm.
you will have one button, capacity, with the cap symbol. You are able to see? At the bottom, one button is there, capacity.
Okay. The bottom is not showing, it's a little hiding.
Yeah, okay, it is coming now. You are able to see?
No.
Not yet, not yet.
Okay, okay.
Now it's coming, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Now
yeah.
Say again what you started trying to say before.
Yeah. Okay, so the capacity related fields data we will maintain in this button.
I see.
I'm just clicking this button, then it will open another screen.
Okay.
This is important.
Mm-hmm.
Now you can see it is open the screen, create work center capacity header. Let me know once it is showing to you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. In this screen,
mm-hmm.
First, we will maintain the capacity of this description. Some description you can maintain. Capacity of machine. And here, capacity responsible is nothing but a person, like work center responsible person. You can select the capacity responsible also. Now, this factory calendar is there. Factory calendar means we will maintain a calendar in the plant. So calendar will have the what are the working days, what are the holidays, it will show you. You will maintain in the factory calendar. For example, your plant is running 7 days a week, but this work center is running only 5 days a week. Okay. Your plant is working 7 days a week, but this machine is working only 5 days a week. So in that case, you can create a separate factory calendar and you can assign that calendar here. If you're not assigned anything here, this will consider the your plant factory calendar only. Okay. Next is this machine, as I told you, will work in how many hours? Whether it is working 8 hours, it is working 10 hours.
10 hours, yeah.
Okay. So that working we will maintain in the standard value capacity here, start time and end time. Here we will maintain. Okay. So this we want to measure as hours. So you can maintain here capacity base unit is hour. Okay. And here start time. So when this machine is starting, maybe morning 6 o'clock, you can maintain the time. And when is the ending, when you are stopping this machine? Okay, maybe it is ending at evening 6 o'clock. Okay, 10 hours or 12 hours. And for a lunch break or breakfast break, you are stopping this machine for 2 hours. You can maintain that.
So in other words, when you are working, suppose in one car and assembly plant, and one day you work from 6 to, for example, 3 o'clock, and another day you work from 6 to 5 o'clock, so the next day you will come and change the timing?
So is it a regular practice or it is just for one day?
Well, it's a whole week process, but some other reason one day is a delay or your power problem or some equipment problem and some hindrances, you are not starting the 6 o'clock, you are supposed to starting for some other reason 10 o'clock. So there is a gap 2 hours and you start like 10 o'clock to 3 o'clock, then particular that day you have to come and change in a work center.
No, actually not required. This is a master data. It is just like planned. We are planning to start at 6 o'clock, but actually you can start at 6:30 or 7. We don't know. Okay, but this is just like a planning, means master data. In 1 day or 2 day cases, you don't require to come and change the master data.
I understand, but is that effects on the costing and all this stuff? No.
Anyhow, the costing will different.
Okay.
Because planned is morning 6 to 6, but actually you started at 10 o'clock. So that means you have lost some cost. Okay, this is just a planned. Actual may be a different.
I see.
Your efficiency came down. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So the next field is capacity utilization. Okay. Capacity utilization means for example, in your case, actual planned is 6 to 6 o'clock. But if you are maintaining 6 to 6 o'clock, that is 100% capacity. But out of 6 to 6, you are using only out of 10 hours, you want to work only 8 hours. Then that is a utilization of 80%.
I see.
You are utilizing only 80%.
I see. Okay.
Okay. This field also you can change. Okay. And another field is there, number of individual capacities. Means if this work center is a single mission, you can maintain as a one. If you have this work center as multiple missions, two, three missions. Okay. For example, if this work center is having the two missions, each mission is working 8 hours. So two missions means it is a 16 hours. Okay. If you have the three missions means working of these three, if you add, it is a 24 hours.
So for example, okay, there are two shift in the industry and one is morning shift and the evening night shift. So can you put the two, one plus one, that is two?
So each shift is 8 hours, 8 hours, correct?
Right.
Okay. In that case, you can put here from start date and end date time.
I see.
8 hour, 8 hour means 16 hours. So example, you are starting as morning 6 o'clock and you will maintain here as a 10 o'clock, 16 hours. Okay, so then it is actually the 8 plus 8, 16 hours.
So that will be number of
Now it will come here now. Okay, I am putting here 100% and one capacity. If I press enter, so system will calculate what is the from 8 to 10 o'clock, how many hours it is, 16 hours minus your break time. Minus 2 hours, so 14 hours is your capacity. If I press enter, system will calculate and show here the value, here value. Okay, you can see 14 hours. Okay, so how the system is calculated 14 hours is you based on your start time, end time, breaks and number of capacities. For example, if you have the two capacities, means two missions working from 6 to night 22. Okay, then if I press enter, this 14 will become 28 hours.
I see.
Okay, so if you have multiple missions, you can maintain this as a multiple. Okay, so I'm just putting one only. Okay, and next is in the bottom, you have some tick marks. One is relevant for finite scheduling. You can tick mark this one, but what is finite scheduling, I will explain you during the another subject, capacity planning. Okay, that time I will explain you what is finite scheduling, but you can put this as a tick mark. And overload percentage, for example, you want to overload. Overload means, example, it is working only 14 hours, but one day or some days you want to work more, like 16 hours or 18 hours. So how much overload you want to consider, you can select here percentage, like 10%, 20%. So percentage also you can maintain.
Okay.
Okay. And can be used by several operations, means this work center we will use in routing. Okay, routing means one is like packing, another is like assembling. Okay, these are called the operations. Another is like painting. These are called the operations. Okay, so all these operations, if you are working in the same work center, same mission area, so then you can select this, can be used by several operations. Okay, each operation wise is separate work center, then you don't require this. Okay.
Yes. Okay.
So There is a tick mark long term planning. This is also another subject. Okay, so I will explain you later about this, what is long term plan.
Yeah, I'm sorry, can you repeat what is this can be used by several operations, please?
Yeah, for example, you are doing production. Okay, you are doing the operations. I am showing you the Excel file now. Okay, operations like assembling. Another next step you are doing as painting. You are painting the car, and third step is like you are testing. You are doing testing of your car. These three you are doing to assemble your final product. These are called the operations. These three are called the operations. Okay, so if you are performing the operations in a same work center, same work center like WC001 only you are using for all these operations, then you can tick mark this can be used by several operations.
Yeah, can you show the can you show us please on a in the work center on a SPR, I mean a master data you were talking about operations?
Yeah, that I will next master data, that is
okay
routing, that time I will show you that actually.
Okay.
Yeah, after work center we will go to the routing master data, that time I will show you how to maintain these values there. Okay. So that is the meaning actually, can be used by several operations.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. So once you fill these values in capacity header, you can click on the back button. So it will come back again to the capacities.
Yes.
Tab.
Yeah.
Are you able to see now work center screen?
Yes.
In capacity tab. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is how to go to the capacity screen and come back to work center. Okay. And next thing is here we need to maintain the formulas. We need to maintain the formula. Formula, what is the formula means? For example, you want to produce one car. You want to produce one car. To produce this one car, it is taking 10 hours. Okay? To produce one car, it is taking 10 hours. Okay, for example, I need 5 cars. So how much hours I need to work, means machine hours required?
50.
So how you calculated this?
Multiply by hours.
Correct. How you calculated is like 5
times 10.
5 into 10,
yeah,
divided by 1. Okay, 5 into 10 divided by 1. This is a formula, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, same thing SAP will tell you in a formula. That formula you need to maintain here to calculate your machine time. That is called the processing formula. And this formula you will have the general practices. We won't create generally the formulas, we will use SAP formulas only. SAP has given the formulas. Okay, so we can see production mission requirement, how the system will calculate the mission hours.
I see.
Okay.
If it's a standard setup, then you do the formula production setup Is that the one, number 5, SP00?
For setup, if we are using the setup, then we will use the 5.
And if you are using the labor, then it's
7. Okay.
But there is a other one, labor time.
Yeah, yeah, I'm coming that. Okay. So I will show you that what is that. Okay. So presently I'm selecting the SAP 006.
Okay.
Okay. And now what is there inside of this formula? So I told you this calculation. Okay. If you want to know what is there in the inside of the formula, scroll down. Again, are you able to see that capacity button in the down?
No, it's not a scrolling down. Now okay. It's little more, one more time, please.
Yeah. Now it came?
No.
Your capacity button?
Now it's coming, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Now here you can see other buttons also, like FORM. It is nothing but a formula, okay?
Oh, if FORM click, means formula.
Yeah, you can click this button. Form. Now is it showing one screen, display formula? Are you able to see?
Yeah, it says machine times operation quantity.
Correct.
Divided by base quantity.
Correct. This is what I have explained you, the formula, machine into operation quantity divided by base quantity. So okay. That is nothing but in Excel file you can see 5 into 10 divided by 1.
I see.
Okay. Okay. That is a formula. And in the bottom, you can see formula indicator. In the same screen, you will see the formula indicator. Generate, costing allowed, work center requirements, and then in the right side, allowed scheduling and this one. These formulas can be used in capacities, scheduling and costing also.
I see.
Okay. In the tabs, you can see capacity, scheduling and costing. Okay. So these formulas can be used in capacity calculation, scheduling calculation. Scheduling means calculation of your start time and end time. And third one is costing purpose. Costing purpose is?
So the left side is for formula, which is generate costing. And work center, and the right side PRT and allow is belongs to, in other words, it's relevant with the scheduling and costing.
Correct.
Okay.
Now costing allowed is means related to costing.
Okay.
Okay. Allowed scheduling means related to scheduling purpose.
Oh, I see.
Work center for requirements is relevant for the capacities.
I see.
Okay. So this formula is related to capacity and costing.
Okay.
Okay. In next tab, scheduling is there. That is relevant for the scheduling.
Okay.
So now I will show you the SAP. You ask the SAP 001. If I open that SAP 001 or 2, then this allowed scheduling will be tick marked.
I see.
This work center for requirements, tick mark will not be there. So that means during scheduling, you need to use that formula for mission calculation.
I see.
Okay. So that is the meaning of this formula.
Okay.
Okay. So is it clear this capacities tab?
Yeah.
We maintain the capacity related and we maintain the formula also. Okay.
No. The formula processing formula, the other tab is a setup formula. We don't need that.
We don't require actually.
I see.
You can see actually you can see what is that you are saying. Okay. You have the different buttons here, formula, test formula. It is just like you can enter some values. And you can test whether it is calculating like 1 hour, one car is equal to 5 hours, then 5 cars is equal to 50 hours. You want to create, you can create.
This is a syntax that you check and you check it.
Yeah, you can check it. Correct. Formula is working fine or not. You can check.
Okay. And only in capacity, we just need only two, one capacity category and
Correct.
Processing formula, and nothing, we don't need any other things.
Yeah, other things are not required. If you are using setup, you can enter the setup formula also.
I see.
If you are, okay, that as my our key is not having the setup, I am not maintaining. Okay. Otherwise, if you have the setup key,
yes.
Yeah, you can maintain it here.
Now what about the other side, which says control capacity reduction? We don't need this.
Not required. We can keep the formula.
I see. Okay.
Okay. Now I am going to the next tab, scheduling.
Yeah.
Here also, you are able to see scheduling details, scheduling tab.
Yes.
Okay. Now here, capacity category. So yes. It is nothing but our mission 001.
Same thing means.
Okay. And here also for scheduling calculation also, we will maintain the formula.
So if you, when you put the capacity category and you enter it, I think automatically the all the formulas will pulled up here.
No, no, it won't come.
I see.
You need to enter manually. Okay. Now here you need to select the SAP 002 because this is related to your scheduling purpose. Okay. Not the SAP 006. Mission requirements is for capacity calculation. Mission time, production mission time is for scheduling purpose.
Okay. We are working on a scheduling.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. You want to see, you can scroll down. Mm-hmm. I am scrolling down.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I am clicking on the formula. Now you can see. Are you able to see display formula screen?
No, you.
Not yet, it's coming maybe.
Yeah, it is coming.
Yeah, now as I can see. Yes, it's
Can I drop the call? How long would it take us to do this? Because I have another call.
Yeah, 1 minute only. I will stop it. After this screen, I will save it. That's all. Okay.
Thank you.
So now you can see the formula SAP 002. Now tick mark is allowed scheduling.
Yeah, and other work center is checked off.
Is removed. Yeah, checked off. That is the reason this formula we need to only use for the scheduling purpose.
I see.
Okay. Okay. I am closing this and I am saving it. In this screen only, we will enter these two only. Capacity category and formulas.
Okay.
We don't require to enter anything. Okay.
Yeah. Just 1 second, let me copy it, please.
Yeah. So I will stop now the class, okay? And I'm saving it.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow I will tell you what is costing, what is the costing tab details.
Okay.
All
right.
Okay.
Thanks
yeah.
to you.
Thank you. Thank you. And have a nice day. Bye.
In other words, I mean, in the work center, when you are working scheduling, you go with the time. If you are working with capacity, you go with the
work center requirement.
Okay, that's
correct.
The but this is also very important. Work center is and capacity is very important because
yes,
these
correct.
Are related then when you work with the routing. So
correct,
these are very important things.
Correct.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Have a nice
saving it. Yeah, have a nice night. Have a nice okay, bye.
Bye-bye.